Hi, Jan here from Jan's Art. I've just started a mystery painting, 20 inches by 16 inches, and I'm using titanium white, cerulean blue, to paint in the sky first. Then I've just done a very basic landscape of a field, distant mountains, and a foreground. And this is day one. Now we go on to day two. Hi everybody, Jan here from Jan's Art. Welcome to day two of my mystery painting. I've got my palette, titanium white, I've got lemon yellow, I've got cadmium yellow deep, which is this orangey colour. I've got yellow ochre, I've got emerald green, I've got sap green, I've got some Indian red. Dioxide purple, cerulean black, and I've just mixed up a blue there because I'm going to have a go just tidying up this sky, this mountain range. That's it. So what I need to do is little brush like this, little round brush, just get it damp and just roll it in my blue. See I'm rolling it into the lighter blue. And all I want to do is just go over this. Going over it, I'm just pushing it back into the distance, see, because it's just standing out too much. So I'm just bringing it back, pushing it back, sorry, not bringing it back. You know what, I'm pushing it back too much. So what we'll do is we'll add a bit more blue, maybe a touch of black, let's see what this gives us. It's a bit grey, so let's add a little bit more white, a little bit more blue. Get this blue that I want. Oh, that's a better blue. That's a much better blue. Okay. It's like a warm grey blue. Right, let's just try this. Okay, that's better. Looks light. Never happy. An artist is never happy. So always want to change something. Maybe add a little bit touch of this purple. Oh, so that's the colour. Hey, look at that. See the colour I'm getting there? Creamy palette knife. Brush. Let's see what this is like. Okay. That's a little bit better. A bit more blue in it, I think. And that's a colour. That's better. That's a colour I want. See? Just trial and error a lot of the time. You've got to have the patience to give it a go. you're not happy with it, change it. I'm just going over the edges, the tops, so I get what I call a clean profile of the mountain range against the sky. And tip it in the valleys below. That's it. That's much better. This is a much better colour than the blue I had originally. But you want to check my brush. I'm getting really fine. So I'm going to try a fine brush. Teeny weeny little fine brush here, see? Very fine. I've got finer ones, but it's a nice little round pointy one. And it just lets you go into places the other brush wouldn't let me. And it holds a little reservoir of paint to do enough. That's it. A little bit of more water, I think. I'm using a stay wet palette, and my stay wet palette is just sponge, wet sponge, damp sponge underneath an old canvas sheet. I like to use an old canvas sheet instead of paper, because paper just tears and rots and wrinkles. But a canvas sheet is used to paint on it, so it does last a little bit better. Might last years, actually, tell you the truth. That is such a better colour. Can you agree? Just bring it down. There we go. Now I've just noticed something that's annoying me to hell. This mountain peak here, I've dropped it too far because this one looks like it should carry on. So I need to make this one a little bit bigger. So now I have to match that colour in a new palette. So let's see if I can remember what the colour was. This is what makes art really fun, trying to remember the colour you used. So let's get my palette knife. There's my palette knife. Now I know I had a little bit of white in there, and I know I had a little bit of purple in there, and I know I might have had a little bit of Indian red in there. Now, a quick way to test the colour is keep it on your palette and put it up against where you're going to use it and think, nah, that's the wrong colour. I need to work on it a bit more. Okay. So I'm going to add a little bit of yellow ochre. Well, see if I'm starting to get what I want. Okay. I think a little bit more white. something. Definitely getting something. I'm going to add a bit of green. You know what? I'm not going to mix. I've decided I'm not. Because this is just an underpainting. So I can get away with redoing it. And this is a far away green. What I'm going to do with this brown, this greeny browny purple colour, right. I'm going to get a flat brush. Yeah, nice flat brush, see? Dampen it. Get rid of the excess. Just load me flat brush, see? So it's loaded with a colour. And wow. There's no going back now, is there? Hey? Just strengthen. It just some faded out green. Let's just work on the top parts. That's it. I think that brass green's much better, I think. That's it, let's let it fade in. These are far away. So let's get some, maybe a little bit of white in that. That's better, see? I'll just bring it up to the tops. That's it. So you get that distance effect, see? Let's get some of that green back. Just redo some of this. Else, just bring it down, drag it into the turmoil below. So I've got a little bit, it's a little bit darker near the outline, see? That's what I wanted. I just wanted a little bit darker. That's it. Now that looks so much better now. That peak, that ridge.
I only have a reference of this range. I don't have it. I've never been there. But it's just a rough representation of where it is. This is not the subject of my painting. This is where it's just located. The subject of my painting is going to be around here. But I wanted to do the background first because it'd be too fiddly to try and do the background. I did the subject. So, see? What is going on, lovely? Right, I just want to take a reference. Lots of sandy bits and stuff. That's what I'm trying to convey. See, and I'm just putting in some dry brushing. Smudging it in just to give me a little bit of something. Clean your brush, get rid of the water, one of my lights. Oh, you're just far away. With this dry brusher, you can do this, you see, you can just push everything back into the background. There we go. That's all I'm doing, I'm just pushing it. Something happening over here. So let's get a bit of something, a bit of lightness going on there. So I just want to do that. That far distance, see? Just enough. Try brush some texture into there, see? Oh, I'm so more happier with this effect. And all I'm doing is try brushing it into that top layer, see? So it gives you adding, you know, just there, see? Now I want a little bit of yellow ochre over here, I think, with a little bit of white. A little bit of purple, and strong, but just want to give it that. Maybe a bit stronger, but add a little bit more white. Just to bring it back. That's it. Colour first time there, but sometimes it takes you forever, other times you can get it straight away. Right. So I have a box of rags. And I found a bit of a rag. They move around in my studio. People, I think, come in at night and move all my rags when I'm not watching. Do you know what I mean? You suffer from the same fate, you lot. Right. Oh, a little bit more white, I think. Maybe a little bit of lemon yellow. White. That's better. Let's just dry brush this. Maybe just a few little scripts along there. Maybe some scripts along, dry brush scripts along the bottom bit, see? Get some white in this green that I had before. That's what I want to do. Get some white. Get the colour in between the green and this nice brown I've got. Just put in some far distance into these. That's it. Let's put some distance in there, see? Maybe, just maybe, add a little bit of green. Maybe which is a little bit of smattering of dry brush up just to get that distance going. Put it on the bottom of the hit, I'm just dry brushing that in, see? There we go. When you're dry brushing, it gives you that lovely effect. Just notice something. You always notice something when you're trying to do something and then you notice something else. Just lighten. This far distant hill thing. Just want to lighten it. See, because this is more central and it looks lighter. If it was darker, it would look closer. And it's further away in the distance. So I want to do that by making it look lighter, see? You paint mountains, full mountains, with these, when you're an artist. There we go. Now that, to me, is a vast improvement. It's in the distance. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to get a middle tone and maybe just add a little bit to this side and dry brush it in. There we go. So you get a bit of light coming from there. So getting light from there going under there. That's fine. I like that. Still got these colours. There we go. Good. There we've got a little bit of light here, look. Just enough to make it more. There we go. See? Now that is such an improvement over what it was. Just adding a bit of features. doesn't dip in so much this. Let's just bring this. Spit out there, see? What I'm gonna do now. Green, strong green just at the top. A little bit ultramarine. Because ultramarine, it's a makes lovely greens. It's a little touch of ultramarine. It's got green in it. So when you add it to a green, you get a lovely darker green. A blowy green. To it.